The big take today was that she deleted and destroyed massive amounts of evidence. And we think that both trials should be thrown out because it's ridiculous. They should be thrown out. And I, frankly, am the one that suffered damages. I should be given money, given damages.
After a jury found Donald Trump guilty of sexually abusing E. Jean Carroll and defaming her, today the court was supposed to decide what the penalties will be in that civil case. It was a tumultuous day for Donald Trump, but he would have you believe that it wasn't Donald Trump who suffered a loss in the court system. He's the very person who should be paid after he was found guilty of engaging in this terrible behavior. Like, I mean, you gotta hand it to him, John. This guy like really has no shame. Like, he is willing to flip the script on anything and anyone, even when he is so demonstrably in the wrong.
I mean, beyond demonstrably in the wrong, he said that's why blah, 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 this thing I made up is why the trial should be dismissed. The trial's done. We're not in a trial now. You're just there to figure out how much money you have to pay. You're guilty. That already happened. We went through this whole thing and the jury came back. You sexually abused her. The trial's done. If you wanted to present your stupid evidence, then you could have tried to do that then. It is too late for that. All that we're determining now is how much you owe, with a side order of how many other defamation lawsuits are you going to be hit with, because you and your lawyer, Alina Haba, are continuing to defame her on a daily basis.
No, that's the amazing thing about this. So he loses the defamation suit and then goes on to continue defaming E. Jean Carroll, the very woman who filed the defamation suit against him, which is why he's now facing a second defamation trial by E. Jean Carroll. Like, does he not have anyone around him, like a family member, someone who like pulls him aside and just says, listen, I'm looking out for you. Stop doing this. You're hurting yourself. No. But maybe he's uncontrollable. Who knows? It would fall on deaf ears. Who knows? But like, he is his own worst enemy. And it is amazing that he like brazenly breaks the law, brags about it. And then when there are penalties for it, he'll turn around and make himself out to be the victim. It blows my mind. And it works. It works with his base. It works.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it partially works with his base. In this case, the fact that he was found guilty of sexually abusing her works with his base, because a significant amount of his base doesn't believe that raping a woman being raped matters. They don't care. They don't think that that's a serious thing. They think that a man being accused or having done that and facing consequences is worse. They implicitly believe everything that he says, like it's insane the hold that he has over them. But then also, like, when was the last time you heard anyone even talk about the fact that he'd been found guilty of sexually abusing her? I mean, I don't even think like CNN and MSNBC are talking about it. Certainly not, you know, the people who are trying to beat him in a primary, ostensibly. Nikki Haley and Ron DeSantis are talking about the fact that, again, this is not like he's on trial. He was found guilty a while ago. They don't even mention it. Isn't that wild? When has there ever been an election, a contested election, where they just let it slide that someone was found guilty of sexually abusing someone?
I don't think that they let it slide. It's just that reporting on it makes no difference, like at all.
Well, I mean, the difference it would make is it would hurt them. Nikki Haley pointing out that he sexually abused someone would hurt her, which is everything you need to know about the Republican base.
I don't understand it. I've never seen anything like this before. I mean, some of the more minor things, I mean, in the context of Donald Trump, the relatively minor things would have like sunk anyone else's political career. But he has this ability, like he has this hold on his base that's, again, something I've never seen or experienced in politics before. Now, I want to note that prior to him making that statement in the video we showed you, he had a back and forth with the judge that would not bode well for someone who's looking to minimize the damages he's going to be ordered to pay. So at one point, the judge threatened to kick him out of the courtroom. And he just basically said, like, I would like that. I would like if he did that. Like, He's just not at all, it seems like he's not at all bothered by the mounting legal woes he's dealing with. On one hand, he talks about using his second term, should he get elected again, to basically launch retaliatory efforts and revenge against his political opponents. On the other hand, he just seems completely unbothered by the consequences for his own actions. It's, I think, a sign of someone who has really gotten away with a lot throughout his lifetime. And so maybe it hasn't really sunk in yet that there are going to be consequences for some of his actions. Who knows? But again, he really does tend to be his own worst enemy. He just can't keep his mouth shut. It's incredible.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.